Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Halo Kids.
Ayen Nur Aini Pruitasari.
M. Hesti Wulandari.
Ayem Dinda Salsabila.
Ayem Fedora Salmakila.
Ayem Nabila Zahwa Azahra.
Ayem Nur Hikmah.
We will tell you
about the story
Fatimah Zahra binti Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Let's look at the following story.
Fatimah binti Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Fatimah is the youngest daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Khadijah. Even though she was born into a well-to-do family, little Fatimah did not have awareness like children from the oppressed tribal at the time. Her own mother Khadijah did when she was small.
Apart from being close to her father, Fatimah was also close to the four her father. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam once said, "Fatimah is myself, my and blue. Whatever troubles here also troubles me, and whatever brothers here also brothers me." Hajar Ibnu Abdul Bar.
When Fatimah was 5 years old, when the appointment of the Prophet Muhammad occurred, Fatimah's life changed completely, however, because she was still small. Fatimah did not yet understand how difficult life was for Muslim at the time.
However, as the day went by, he increasingly understood that many people had his father and mother. Many people who used to work with them were close, them were now all far away. In fact, his uncle and his own family were hostile to his father. Once little Fatimah saw people putting camel dung while her father was praying.
Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam remained prostrate and did not lift her head. When she felt the ground stick to her back and shoulder, little Fatimah cried when she saw him. He rushed over to his father and climbed up the deer. He felt very annoyed when the bad guys looked heavily.
Day by day, the cruelty of the Quraysh increased. They ostracized, criticized, and generously and even boycotted all Muslim activities, resulting in Muslim falling into poverty, including Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam family. Khadijah's wealth was used up to finance the struggle to uphold Islam. So every little Fatimah has been used to living a simple life since real good.
When she grew up, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam married Fatimah to Ali, a young man who has noble qualities. He was the cousin of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. After married, Fatimah lived in her husband's house. The house is really simple. There is no furniture whatsoever.
The distance between Fatimah's house and her father's house is very far. This means that Fatimah cannot visit her father too often. He also couldn't participate in all his father's activities too often. However, Fatimah remains obedient. When her husband is away, she will look after the household.
After Khadijah, his love, wife Bin and Fatimah, his daughter left so far away. Rasulullah SAW felt sad and lonely. Rasulullah SAW planned to give Ali and Fatimah a house that was closer. Of his friends, Harithah bin Nu'am heard this news. And he also gave up his house for Fatimah to live in. Subhanallah.
Fatimah is used to doing all the housework alone, starting for clean house, cooking, washing clothes to fetching water. His life was so simple, his clothes were always full of dust and charcoal.
Fatimah's life became more complete when she had 4 sons and a daughter. They are Hasan, Hussein, Zainab, and Umu also. Rasulullah Shallallahu Alaihi Wasallam loved his grandchildren very much, especially Hasan and Hussein. In fact, Rasulullah Shallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Both of them are the jealous of my heart in the world."
Taking care of the house and taking care of the children alone is not an easy thing. Moreover, at the time, the life of Muslims were very difficult. One day, Fatima complained to her husband. At the time, Fatima thought, "What if we ask the Messenger of Allah, a prisoner of war, as a servant?"
However, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam refused his doctor request. At the time, there was a more urgent need, namely selling the prisoners of war, and the money with the sale would be used to buy food supplies for all Muslims. Fatima and Ali could express this reason, but their heart felt sore.
That evening, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam meet his doctor and son-in-law. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "I shall tell you something better than what you asked earlier when you want to sleep. Read the takbir 30 times, tasbih 30 times, and tahmid 30 times. This is better than a serpent."
The ones on Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam body were so deep that the boat could not stop following. For this land, Fatima nursed her father until he recovered. Even though she has to fast this every day, Fatima is never afraid. She continued to fight alongside her father, husband, and all other Muslims.
Wars continued to occur between Muslims and people who had Islam. Fatima and other women also fought. There were attacks with 30 injured soldiers and preparing food and drink. In the Battle of Uhud, Fatima's heart was set when she had to care for her food.
One day, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam became so ill that she couldn't move. Fatima also visited her father. At the time, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam whispered something to Fatima. However, Fatima didn't want to tell anyone about her father whispered. Not long after that, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam died.
It was only after her father died that Fatima told what her father had whispered. It turned out that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that his illness would soon end in death, and Fatima was the one in his family who would follow him the fastest. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also said that Fatima was the leader of the woman in heaven apart from Maryam binti Imran. And it turned out to be true. 6 months after Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam died, Fatima became seriously ill and then followed her father.